Good morning, Framingham High School, and welcome back to Flyer News. On today's episode, we will update you on the weather, which, from what I hear, is a little bit confusing.
We'll also be getting a preview from Maggie Freese of Sideways Stories, which is the drama company's latest show.
And of course, it wouldn't be a Friday without Pat and Alex's sports update. Even though no sports are happening right now, they have still found a way to entertain us.
All that and more on Flyer News. Good morning, Framingham, and welcome back to Flyer News. I'm Julie Carson.
And I'm Evan Marinofsky. Today is Friday, and day six, with periods running D, A, B, E, G.
As of the weather has been very warm for March, but there are rumors that we may be getting some more winter early next week.
Yes, unfortunately, I've heard those rumors too. Luckily, we have Lacey Edwards here to give us all the details.
Good morning, FHS. So we've had a pretty mild couple of weeks, but there is still much more cold air in store for this weekend. Today is a pretty comfortable day with temperatures ranging in the 40s and 50s. However, a cold front moving in from the west will allow for some gusty PM showers along with temperatures dropping into the low 20s throughout the night. Tomorrow will be nice and sunny, but a bit chillier in terms of temperatures ranging in the low 40s. And from Sunday to Monday, temperatures will drop down to the 30s, so we can definitely expect some heavier PM and AM snow showers. Tuesday and Wednesday will be comfortable, quiet, and partly sunny, while on Thursday, we are anticipating some scattered rain showers. Overall, this weekend is extremely varied in terms of temperature and precipitation, so be prepared. This has been Lacey Edwards with WeatherWatch. We'll take it back to the desk.
The town has recently begun an investigation into reports of a hostile work environment created by a local candidate for selectmen. According to Bob Helton, the manager, investigation is involving Deborah Butler. A town employee felt threatened by the incident under investigation, currently by a third-party attorney. Butler has already addressed the investigation several times in the past week at various meetings. Butler suggests that it is no more than a witch hunt on behalf of the town, according to the Metro West Daily News. However, Halpin challenged the statement, saying that much of what Butler was saying was factually inaccurate. This is Butler's second time running for a seat on the board.
Over the past bunch of years, FHS has built up an incredibly successful drama company.
That is correct, and tomorrow night they add on another show to their impressive resume.
And with more on the show, Sideways Stories, we have Maggie Freese to preview it.
This is our 14th year entering festival, and I'd say this year the content is very different than what we're used to doing. We wanted to pick a really fun children's theater piece this year, so we chose Sideways Stories from Wayside School. It's one of my favorite books from growing up, and it's a piece of children's theater that I've always loved and have talked to Donna about for years and years.
For me, this is my first festival play being in it, so I don't really have anything to compare it to, but comedy is more natural for me. I love comedy movies. I would say that I wouldn't underestimate how hard it is. It is surprisingly hard to make people laugh. And I think it's easier to make people cry on stage than it is to make people laugh. So Definitely a challenge.
The process has been incredibly different in that we started rehearsals with a month of workshops where we just worked with the company to build specific skills that would aid them in the performance of the show rather than staging the show and running it and running it and running it, because we wanted to keep it fresh and alive and exciting for the actors and for the audience.
The biggest reward that has come from being stage manager is getting to see everyone's work put on stage and seeing the world of the play be presented so beautifully, because as stage manager I've had such an individual relationship with every single person in the company, and I love seeing the pride that everyone has after a really good run, and seeing the intensity that everyone works with throughout the process. It's really cool.
The benefit was originally designed to actually fund our festival experience because there wasn't enough money to pay for buses, for the truck rental. So we held a benefit performance for $10 a ticket, and it's historically stayed the exact same price since 2003. And that money goes directly to fund the festival experience for all of our students. We use that as a dry run for our Saturday performance. So the cast and the crew get a chance to do it before they actually do it, and to make any mistakes or to have any celebrations that they have yet to have with an audience in the house. So it's a really useful performance for us. We already had one for prelims. There are over 500 people at that performance, and we hope to have a bunch of people see it this Friday. So we hope you'll come and see it. Support us.
The body of Zach Marr, a 22-year-old Harvard man, was discovered in the Charles River. The body was found near Paul Revere Park in the Everett Circle once around 6 p.m. that day. Marr had been missing since February 13th, over a month ago. He had been last seen leaving the Bell in Hand Tavern, where he was out with friends and family. According to police, they assumed that he wandered into the area and at some point fell into the river. There was no obvious trauma suffered by Marr, and his family held a press conference on Wednesday in Harvard to thank everyone involved in searching for their beloved son. Marr was only 22 and a student at Mount Wachusett Community College.
Well, it wouldn't be Friday without sports updates.
That's right, but I'm wondering what they're going to do about without winter sports starting up yet.
I've heard rumors of an office theme show. I'm not 100% sure, though.
Well, let's watch it to find out.
Hello.
Hi, do you want to go to a party with me?
No, the game's on.
Oh, I almost forgot. I'll be right there.
We like sports and we don't care who knows. From shooting hoops to the Super Bowl. We like sports and we don't care who knows.
Football, tennis, hockey, golf.
Good morning, Birmingham High School. My name's Alexine Bruno.
And I'm Patrick Cassidy, and this is Sports Update.
With spring season still waiting, we're going to take this moment to recap winter sports.
That's right, so let's just hop right into it. Coach Torbert's boys basketball team qualified for the state tournament this year, and they defeated the 2 seed of Holy Name. Shout out to Mikey Bradley for being selected as an all-star, and Jamie Drucker for getting an honorable mention.
Yeah, I've been pretty much skating my whole life. Thought about playing in the NHL, but it's just so much traveling.
You had no time to spend with your wife and kids. And I really want a wife and kids.
Boys ice hockey came in first in the BSC Carey division with a record of 12-1-2, and all-star nominations are still being considered, so we'll get back to you on those.
The cheer team earned themselves a spot in the state finals after they finished third in the BSC meet here at FHS. They're in search for a national championship. Shout out to all-stars Dina Yoho and Brennis Hogebrook.
Coach Kanovich's wrestling team finished their season with a 13-9 record and came in 12th place in the All-States Championship.
Shout out to Marlon Lamas, Michael Ramos, Joe Tolson, and Pablo Ogata for having especially great seasons.
Boys swim finished with a record of 6-2 and came in 6th place in the South Central Championship. They also came in 8th place in the D1 State Championship.
Led by captains Molly Cove Rubius and Emily Devon, girls ice hockey picked up 3 pretty impressive wins over BSC rival teams. That was pretty cool. And with only 5 sophomores and 3 freshmen, we're looking at a bright future for girls hockey.
Although girls basketball's record may not have reflected their true abilities, they used their season time to give back to the community by conducting youth clinics. All-stars include Lauren Gemelli as an honorable mention. So I guess you could say girls basketball will catch you on the flippity flip.
Flippity flip!
The dance team finished third place in the hip-hop division and finished sixth place in the New England Championships. So, pretty great season, might I add. Shout out to first team All-Star Ariel Luria and also Bruno Barbalo for getting an honorable mention.
Both boys and girls track teams had 9 state qualifiers, and the girls relay team came first in the D1 championship. Shout out to Ashley Wilson for being a first team All-Star and Paul Halberstadt and Zoe Carter for being honorable mentions.
The Alpine ski team scored more points in race competition this year than in any year previous than this one. Duh. The team has Jared Brockway on it, and I know him. Great job.
Well, go Flyers. And that's all we have for you today. I'm Patrick Cassidy.
And I'm Alexine Bruno. This has been Sports Update. Have a good one.
Oh, we've hit that time of the show again, the pledge.
And today we have the Key Club officers here to lead us. Take it away.
Please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Have no place to go. Have no place to go. Darling,
Good morning, FHS. Today is Friday, March 18th, a day 6 with periods running D, A, B, E, G. METG Festival Play semifinal round benefit will be tonight at 7 in the auditorium. Also, the video game tournament is today after school in E202. The sign up is $5. And students, please remember, do not move your vehicles down to the gym area after school or you will be ticketed and or towed. Also, guys, the library will be closed during the school on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday of next week due to MCAS. If you need the library any of those days, it'll be open normal hours before and after school. That's it for me. More announcements. Hi, Jake.
Good morning. Good morning, everybody. So, again, take a picture of me and post it, please. I'm not vain, I promise. I just want to win money. So, yeah, do that. Post it on Instagram. You know the hashtag by now. It's everywhere. Also, please buy your hypnotist tickets. Can we play the promo for that? Sweet.
You cannot be hypnotized against your will.
All right, so you just saw that awesome promo. Tickets are $10. You can buy them from me or any of the people being hypnotized. And those people are Emma Feinblatt, Kevin Scranton, Ayanna McKay, Jamie Miller, Eddie Lynch, Luis Munoz, Grace Seda, Bruno Barbalio, Eli Bondar, Sid Wishnow, Bruno Pereira, Kirsten Santos, Ali Minkall, Will Luz, sorry if I butched that, Aaron Babineau, Trevor Michael Smith, Nat Buida, and there's some others, TBD. But we'll let you know if there are others picked. But those are the people as of right now, so you can buy from any of those people, or me, or a class of 2016 officer. If you see a bag with pink tickets, please buy them.
Morning, ladies.
All right. Hi, everyone. We're from Key Club. So yesterday we went out to pick up some trash from the junior lot. We went out not expecting too much, so we thought it'd be like one or two bags. Turns out we picked up around 5 bags full of trash, and it was pretty gross. So moral of the story, keep your school clean. There's plenty of trash cans around the school. There's no need to throw it on the ground.
Yeah, especially in the junior lot, it was pretty gross. And so don't do that. That's kind of gross. Also, those of you who feel remorse for what you did and feel bad about throwing trash everywhere, you can come next week because Key Club has another trash pickup day next week. The date we're still not sure about, but if you ask any of the officers or look at the Facebook group, you'll figure it out. So yeah, please just keep your school clean. It was like really gross.
Hi. Good guys. Morning.
Good morning.
So today we have a captain's practice. This is the last one ever for the rest of eternity at 2:30 in between the gyms. So today is a special one because we're going to be doing the chocolate milk run. So you get a bunch of chocolate milk. Entry fee is $3. And it's going to be fun.
Meet at the front field at 2:30. Go Flyers.
Good morning, Isabella.
Good morning.
Good morning and happy Friday to everybody. A few other kind of reminders from yesterday's announcements. We did indicate that the students that are in study halls in the cafeteria may certainly eat and use the vending machines when they're down there. The students that during the lunch period that are in studies in the room, not the case, okay? So we would also appreciate it if you get a pass from the teacher when you're using the restroom down by the auditorium. Also, the physical education people would prefer that you do not use the vending machines down by their area when classes are on and in sessions during the day as well. Next week is going to be a big week, particularly for sophomores and students that have not taken the MCAS test before. Strong attendance and getting here in a timely manner is totally encouraged as far as students are concerned. It's the ELA test. On Tuesday, it's going to be the long comp. And on Wednesday and Thursday, it's going to be the ELA sessions 1 and 2, which are mostly reading comprehension. I would strongly advise teachers of those sophomores that are taking the exam go a little bit easy on their own testing next week, and you might want to diminish some of the assignments as well so that they can give their best possible effort. Get a good night's sleep, have some breakfast, and don't stress out, but give your best possible effort. We'll be talking a little bit more about it toward the end of next week. Stay warm. We might have a snowstorm on Monday, possibly Sunday afternoon, so be in tune with that too. Have a great weekend and a good day today. Thanks.
Period D, guys.
Well, that's a wrap on this week, but if you'd like to catch us again, tune in at 5 and 8 o'clock on channels
8 Comcast, 15 RCN, and 41 Verizon Fios. You can also watch us on YouTube. I'm Julie Carson.
And I'm Evan Marinofsky. Have a great weekend, FHS.